Trinity is our first advanced technology system. It provides the NNSA, as well as Lawrence Livermore, Los Alamos, and Sandia National Laboratories, the ability to do large-scale nuclear weapons simulation, but it also gives us the ability to look at what we think are technologies that are forward-looking.
There's a lot of advancements in processors or computing nodes or everything else, but what a system like Trinity does is allow you to put all of that together at scale. How do these technologies work together, or do they work at all?
It's one of the key elements in the overall stockpile stewardship program because it allows us to do simulations at large scale, but not only can we do larger problems that we haven't been able to do before, but we can do them more quickly. Trinity is a top 10 machine as it relates to the amount of operations per second that we can do. However, it's not just the speed of Trinity that's important, but how efficiently that we can use that speed.
Ultimately, the most rewarding time is when you see scientists run applications on this system and get some real results that help them define new things in their area of science that we've never seen before.
We have gotten results from a project that seeks to implement a new kind of neural network called a sparse prediction machine. A sparse prediction machine differs a bit from the sort of deep neural networks that you might have been reading about in the popular press, in that it's more biologically realistic. One result of this is we can train a sparse prediction machine in much the way a biological system learns. And we also hope to apply these algorithms to large-scale computer simulations, say large-scale simulations of the weather, for example, so that we can learn maybe more about the underlying processes that govern weather dynamics and also make better predictions about what the future weather might be. Los Alamos has principal responsibility for guaranteeing the integrity of some components of the United States stockpile. And we have to do this entirely without testing. So part of the way we do this is through large-scale computer simulations. And we believe a sparse prediction machine might be able to contribute to the analysis and even acceleration of simulations of this type.
This model is a lot larger than most models. And so we are simulating what's called chromatin, which is basically a little chunk of one of your chromosomes. We're able to do a much larger portion of DNA with this. Trinity is one of the only computers in the world that can fit this problem onto the computer and fit it in memory. The DNA is packed into the cells by wrapping around these spools, and we were able to simulate many, many of the spools together with the DNA on this platform. It was really thrilling to see it on the screen, to see all the different spools interacting and so forth. There are many different applications. The main ones are in embryo development, understanding how the embryo develops and developmental diseases, and also in cancer. This gene we're simulating is called GATA4, and it's related to gastrointestinal disease and gastrointestinal development. So if we can understand the shape of this gene, how the dynamics of it, how it responds to drugs, we may have a chance to find cures for those kinds of cancer.
VPIC is one of the highest performing particle and cell plasma codes in the world. Being able to run VPIC on Trinity enabled us to do was to run problems at unprecedented sizes and unprecedented scales. And this was really something that let us make discoveries at kind of the forefront of mix and turbulence and plasmas that nobody else in the world has been able to do. What we're trying to do is we're trying to look at the way plasmas will mix with one another. We see this happen in astrophysical plasmas. We see this occur in the Earth's magnetosphere. We also see this happen on Earth as well, in plasmas, for instance, in inertial fusion experiments. One of the advantages for us going to this platform is that it kind of presages what machines of the future may look like. The design changes we made to the code today are ones that we anticipate using in the future. The lab has a national security mission. It involves nuclear weapons, worrying about our energy security. It involves protecting our space assets. The problems that we're working on as part of this open science project are really helping with that whole spectrum of, of different application areas for the lab's national security mission.
It's working with great people across a multitude of organizations that make this work.
We've been able to solve some problems within the stockpile that we've never been able to solve before. So that's exciting in and of itself. Having a unique capability and being able to do new things with it is always enjoyable.